Monday, 20th August, and this is Top Stories by Rooster News. After 5 days of extremely heavy rain and floods that ravaged several parts of Kerala, Sunday brought respite following a gradual decrease in rainfall and receding water levels in flood-affected areas, particularly Chengannur and Chalakudy. With 13 persons killed in rain-related incidents on Sunday, the toll since August 8th stood at 210. Chief Minister Pinarayi Vijayan, who said rescue operations were in the final round, said priority would now be given to providing safe drinking water and restoring both electricity and water supply. A total of 7,24,649 displaced persons have been housed in 5,645 relief camps, he told reporters. The Chief Minister said 6 health officers would be deployed in each panchayat to ensure that there was no outbreak of any communicable diseases as the flood water recedes. The state government would distribute 36 lakh textbooks free of cost to school children who had lost their books in the floods, he added. The Tamil Nadu Hotels Association has announced a 5% discount on the bill if customers bring their own utensils and bags for food parcels. The association, with over 10,000 members, has passed a resolution to this effect. On average, each food parcel costs us around 3-4% of the bill amount. If customers bring their own utensils, they can benefit. We have asked members to put up boards at their restaurants informing the customers about the offer, said M. Ravi, President, Chennai Hotels Association. The discount move follows a Tamil Nadu government order banning single-use plastics from January 1, 2019. Takeaways make up a big portion of food sales, and the association says its decision would reduce the use of plastics substantially. But some restaurants are also pushing the envelope in their fight against plastics. They are now packing food in banana leaves. We're looking at alternatives like aluminum foil and cardboard boxes, since not everyone can bring their own utensils, said Vishnu Shankar of Adyar Ananda Bhavan in Chennai. When Prime Minister Narendra Modi announced India's first human space flights mission on a rocket built by ISRO on Independence Day last week, a widely appreciated clause was his promise that it would be a son or daughter who would take the Indian flag to outer space. At the Indian Space Research Organization, or ISRO, a part of PM Modi's promise has already been kept. The space agency has deputed Dr. V.R. Lalitambika, an experienced engineer, to head the astronaut program. A skilled taskmaster, control systems engineer Dr. Lalitambika, has spent 3 decades at ISRO and has been tasked to send an Indian astronaut into space by 2022. She has worked on all Indian rockets, Polar Satellite Launch Vehicle, or PSLV, Geosynchronous Satellite Launch Vehicle, GSLV, and Indigenous Space Shuttle. The 56-year-old studied in Kerala and has 2 children. The only Indian citizen to have flown into space is Wing Commander now retired Rakesh Sharma, who flew into space in 1984 on a Russian mission. Since then, 2 women of Indian origin but American citizens, Kalpana Chawla and Sunita Williams, have also flown into space. Indian women engineers have had a glowing past in India's rocket programs. It was India's Agni Putri Tessie Thomas who ably led the Agni 4 and Agni 5 missile programs. Dr. Shashikala Sinha headed the program to secure India from incoming ballistic missiles. Both work at the Defense Research and Development Organization, or DRDO. In addition, the senior-most official at DRDO, Dr. J. Manjula, an avionics expert, is tipped to head the DRDO next. For the first 76 seconds, Bajrang Punya made it look ridiculously easy. The final of the 65kg freestyle wrestling competition on the opening day of the Asian Games looked like yet another walk in the park for the 24-year-old who had won all his previous bouts on the day on technical superiority. It didn't exactly pan out that way, but at the completion stage of his grudge match against Japan's Daichi Takatani, Punya was the proud winner of India's 140th Asiad gold with 11-8 scoreline, the first in this edition, and reiterated his credentials as the brightest spark in the next generation of Indian wrestling and an able successor to the mantle of Yogeshwar Dutt, his mentor. 6 months ago, Punya had gone down to Takatani in the semi-finals of Asian Championships, the only one in the last seven tournaments where he failed to make the final. On Sunday, Punya ensured there would be no repeat of the heartbreak at Bishkek, holding his nerve to the ecstasy of vociferous Indian supporters. Punya has his sights set firmly on bigger targets, the first of which would be the World Championships in October, with an Olympic quota at stake. China's military must resist the corrosion of corruption and ensure the fight against graft is deepened, President Xi Jinping told senior officers, state media said on Sunday, offering a renewed warning against a deep-seated problem. China's military, the world's largest and currently undergoing an ambitious modernization program, has been the important focus of Mr. Xi's campaign against corruption since he took power 6 years ago. Speaking at a three-day meeting of the Central Military Commission, which ended on Sunday, Mr. Xi said the fight against graft must remain always on the road and be deepened, the official Xinhua news agency reported. "Go in hot pursuit of and strike hard against hedonism and extravagance," Xinhua cited Mr. Xi saying. "The anti-corruption fight must be unswervingly grasped and we will not change direction or form." We round up this newscast with fuel prices from key metros. In Delhi, petrol is sold for 77.24 rupees per litre and diesel for 68.90 rupees per litre. In Chennai, petrol is sold for 80.23 rupees per litre and diesel for 72.77 rupees per litre. In Kolkata, petrol is sold for 80.18 rupees per litre and diesel for 71.74 rupees per litre. In Mumbai, petrol is sold for 84.66 rupees per litre and diesel for 73.13 rupees per litre.